Alrighty, guys, so this time around, we got the weapon tier list for Arataki Ito. It's going to be a good one, because we have a lot of tests we've done, and of course, we did something different on this weapon tier list, and of course, we'll go over the video. Jump into it! So if you guys didn't know, I do a lot of weapon tier lists on this channel where we talk about the best weapons for each character. And one of the biggest comments that you guys have been asking me to do more on any of the characters is, can you please start changing the crit ratios from a crit damage headpiece to a crit damage headpiece? Now, as many of you know, that's really difficult to do because getting every artifact in the game is very difficult, and getting headpieces for the different typings that actually match up in stats is very difficult. However, this time I kind of lucked out. Before Arataki Ito, I actually kind of lucked out. I ended up getting a pretty decent artifact set for him on my whale account, and was able to do a pretty good setup for a weapon test. But one other thing that's most notable is I actually ended up getting a crit damage headpiece with defense percentage, and also getting a crit rate headpiece with defense percentage, which is very unheard of for the first time it's ever happened to me. So I'm able to do two different tests this time around to show off a crit rate headpiece and a crit damage headpiece on weapons that I'll be showing in the showcase for each type, so you can see consistency builds as well as spike builds. For weapons today, I'm only going to be able to show each of these 5 stars at R1. I didn't refine any of these just specifically for a weapon test I wanted to show. I have Akamar at R5, Sea Lord R5, I have Servant Spine at R1, Blacklift R5, and I did not try out the Rain Slasher or the Prototype Archaic. And I left the other weapons low refine or low level just because they weren't really relevant for the test. They do work out and I can do the math on them and it just doesn't really matter that much because they're okay. So for the first tier on this list, we have the fire dog shit tier, the trash tier. And of course we have the Rain Slasher, Bell at any refine, the Skyward, I don't remember the name of this weapon because it's never used anywhere. We have the and the Lithic Blade as well as the Royal Sword at R1. So the Lithic and the Royal Sword are at R1. They can't get enough ramp stacks on R1, and the crit rate that you transfer won't be high enough to even matter. And Lithic, you can only use one or two leeway characters at maximum on a team with Arataki Ito, so you won't get a lot of stacks. Going up to the next tier of the tier list, we have more relevant weapons, where we're going to talk about the Akomaru and the Sea Lord the most, and we're going to be talking about those two weapons. They're both attack percentage weapons that are very, very strong. And of course, we have weapons like the Prototype Archaic at R5 and R1. We have the Favonia Sword at R5 and R1. None of this is ordered, by the way, I just threw them all in here. We have the Royal Sword at R5, Sacrificial Greatsword, the Snow Tomb Star Silver, and one of the weapons people are gonna ask me about, of course, is the Defender's the White Blind. This weapon at R1 is definitely okay. It's decent, but it's pretty much on par with all these weapons when it's R1. When it gets higher refines, it's definitely like one of the best weapons, so it's super strong. Between the Akomaru and the Sea Lord, I want to talk about these two really quick. A lot of people are going to have these two weapons right now, and these two weapons are elemental burst weapons. Arataki Ito does not scale at all on elemental burst, so these weapons are not optimal. They do a decent amount of damage, but neither one of these are going to do a very sizable amount of damage for his overall kit, because elemental burst does not factor into any part of his kit, and his damage is basically scaling on normal and charge attack only. Prototype Archaic, however, is a weapon that does have a physical proc on it, and it can do a little bit more extra damage. However, a lot of the damage that you're going to be dealing is not physical, it's going to be geo, so you really can't get too much out of this weapon, and you can't really use this weapon before you ultimate at all. I think at R5 can get a decent amount of stacks to make this on par with pretty much all the weapons on this tier, and you can get an okay amount of stat range, but it's really not the best. Next on the list, we have the relevant tier. Now, these weapons are in order. I'm gonna talk about the Song of Broken Pines first. The Song of Broken Pines is a weapon that actually increases normal attack speed. And Arataki Ito is a character that mostly relies on charge attack speed. By using normal attack speed, you can't really integrate adding in a different set of your rotation until like halfway into the auto attack rotation after your charge attacks. So you can get an okay amount of attack speed, but when attack speed is considered, if you did not know this, attack speed only affects normal attack speed and does not affect charge attack speed. Charge attack speed is actually a unique thing that gets modified part of Arataki's passive that's completely different. And Arataki Ito is a character that completely relies on charge attack speed, again, not normal attack speed, unless you start ramping toward your other ability, in which case it does somewhat rely on it, but it doesn't really increase your DPS by any means whatsoever. The extra 20% attack on it is kind of nice, but again, it's a physical main stat weapon that doesn't really help you too much, but does have a large amount of attack to make it a big difference. The Enforged at R1. This weapon was really interesting. I thought this weapon was not going to do the best, but it actually did a very relevant amount of damage. When I was comparing the damage numbers between the weapons, I actually saw some sizable numbers on this weapon, as well as seeing it on the Wolf Great. On the Wolf Gravestone, and between the two, there were actually very, very similar damage numbers between the two weapons. I was I was kind of impressed by the actual damage that these weapons were putting out, but I was not 100% on board with these weapons because of how much better other weapons actually are. And after trying out Arataki Ito with other weapons, I was very surprised to know that these weapons, again, are not optimal weapons on Arataki Ito because of how his scaling works and how the new defense set and how defense kind of works into the kit. So the way defense percentage works in general versus attack percentage is if you took a weapon with like the Wolf Gravestone, this weapon at maximum has a very large attack percentage on its stat. In fact, the Wolf Gravestone has a total at a 5-star weapon at a 50% extra attack percentage. However, the Wolfskin is a 5-star weapon. And actually, what's funny is that the White Blind, which is a weapon that I actually have lower in the tier list, actually has a 51% defense bonus that's gonna be added on as well. It's also gonna add on an additional 24% attack percentage and an extra 24% defense on top of that. But because the Wolf Greystone does have a higher base attack and it does have a higher attack percentage and attack percentage proc on passive, it does outstrip the White Blind at refine 1, and you can see a bigger difference gain. However, it does change at higher refines. When you look at the weapons like the Black Lift Slasher and the Serpent Spine, both of these weapons are exceptional weapons for statsticks for Arataki Ito. The Black Lift is actually a great weapon for him, and I find one of the better weapons because Arataki Ito's main stat is going to be, of course, a crit chance passive. And because you have a crit chance passive, you can actually synergize that pretty well with his, of course, a crit damage weapon. And of course, if you get a crit chance headpiece, it's a lot easier to, of course, maximize stats. However, the highest damaging option of all the R1 weapons between all the 5-star weapons that we have here, including the Skyward Pry, which the Vorpal Blades do kind of proc out and are pretty cool to watch, the highest damaging weapon of all these weapons is the Serpent Spine. And the reason the Serpent Spine is the highest damaging option is because, of course, it has a percentage damage increase on it, which, of course, Arataki Ito does not have a lot of on his kit. He mostly relies on attack percentage, defense percentage, and, of course, some crit damage and some other effects that are upon his other weapons. However, the Serpent Spine does have the highest damage increase of any weapon. However, it is a weapon with some caveats. This weapon is, of course, a weapon that increases damage that you take, and of course, you will be using shield with Arataki Ito. However, if you are a player without Zhang Li, this is gonna be a kind of a problematic weapon for you because Arataki Ito, of course, increases the damage that you take. So without Zhang Li, you're gonna be sitting there with a very weak shield, and you're actually gonna take a very large amount of damage. There are three big things that I recommend you have to use Serpent Spine in any capacity in order to be a top tier weapon. The first thing, of course, you have to level 90 Arataki Ito so that the defense that you gain is actually going to make it so that you take less damage relative to the enemies that you're fighting. Level actually does affect defense very, very heavily, so if you're not level 90 in Arataki Ito, you'll be taking significantly more damage. And of course, the next thing, of course, you need to have, of course, is Zhang Li at like about 40,000 HP. If you have Zhang Li at about 40,000 HP, you shouldn't have any problems by using the Serpent Spine. It will be an exceptional top tier weapon for you and bear one of the best weapons in the game for him. However, if you don't have those things, both of those two things, it's going to be a lot more damage you're going to take on Arataki Ito. We're going to go to the best overall options for Arataki Ito. Between all the weapons here, we of course have the Refine 5 on 4s, Refine 5 Wolf Gravestone, Refine 5 Skyward Pyre that everyone totally has, but of course, you know, everyone wants to talk about. But all these weapons actually are okay weapons in comparison to, of course, the Serpent Spine Refine 5, which is actually better than a lot of these weapons at like Refine 3 or so. And of course, we got the Blacklist Slasher Refine 5, and of course the White Blind at Refine 5. All of these weapons are the best overall options you can use for Arataki Ito, but 4-star weapons this time around are actually going to be better than most of the 5-star counterparts for Arataki Ito because of how the scaling works for him. I wanted to show this based on a Wolf Gravestone R1 so you guys can get an idea. So we have the White Blind R5 over here with its comparable stat ratios with all the buffs added in. Of course, we have Wolf Gravestone over here with all the buffs added in, and of course, the Wolf Gravestone proc added in as well to see everything. And finally, we have the Serpent Spine at Refine 5 with everything you could add in. Now with all the damage, of course, you can see your damage coming out to about 40,000 over here on the White Blind R5, 37,000 on the Wolf Gravestone, and of course the 45 over here on the Serpent Spine for a DPS ratio, including crit rate and of course crit damage. And I of course changed the stat ratio on the Serpent Spine to accommodate the extra stats given for the Serpent Spine for the extra crit rate it has and converted it to crit damage. Of course, these cuz are the best weapons overall for for the Mad Lad. None of these weapons are in order, of course. Serpent Spine is the highest damaging option, but of course it is a double-edged sword. It is a weapon that, of course, can hit you, of course, while doing damage. Blacklift, of course, is a great weapon in general because of that 72% attack bonus. It's going to give you a really, really sizable chunk in damage overall when you're hit mobbing out with this, but it's going to be probably the worst of the 4-star options if you wanted to compare them, unless you have a very, very large crit rate ratio already, and the Wipe Line is probably going to be the best overall option. I didn't really compare them to these 5-star options over here at Refine 5 because very few players are going to have these at Refine 5, but if you do have them, they will probably still be worse than Serpent Spine R5. They may be better in certain situations, but probably worse than most. But the nice thing about the all the other weapons that are not the Serpent Spine R5 is the Serpent Spine R5 is a weapon that you are going to have to sit there for 20 seconds at the start of every fight for it to be better than everything else. Otherwise, it is the worst overall weapon and does not provide as much damage. In fact, if you actually looked at the weapon at the starting point with a no increased damage modifier, it is actually the worst weapon that you could possibly have for Arataki Ito with zero stacks. But if you only get about half the stacks, let's just say you get move up to about 125% or whatever it may be, or what, I don't know. So you get up to about 130% extra damage or so. That is pretty much with 3 stacks on par with the White Blind when the White Blind's at max stacks. And the White Blind, of course, can keep its stacks high by just auto-attacking a little bit in the rotation, so keeping up the stacks overall. And of course, it has an attack percentage stack and a defense stack, so it is like a little bit different depending on how you want to roll in the stacks. You, of course, have to ramp up the stacks, so it does have a lower DPS window at the start of the fight, so it's a little bit easier. The other problem, of course, is the Blacklift Slasher is a nut same weapon, so all three of these weapons are kind of asterisk weapons, while as the other 5-star compounder parts at Refine 5 will start at strong points and of course end at strong points, but of course the Forge being a little bit different than the other ones I just mentioned. And of course, the best option for Arataki Ito at Refine 1 is going to be the Red Horn Stone Thresher. This weapon is ridiculous. It dumpsters all the other weapons in the game. It is very, very, very strong. That's not even comparable to everything else. But there is a weapon that's even stronger than this for Arataki Ito. It is possibly on par with the Refine 5. Refine 5. Yes, you heard me say it. The Refine 5 Red Horn Stone Thresher. It is in fact the strongest weapon for Arataki Ito. It is the Debate Club because he is the one and only, and of course he needs a club, and you know it's the only club in Genshin Impact, so you better start using it. All right, well, that's gonna do it for this video. My name is Sekipoko. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys didn't do it, of course, like, subscribe, all the fun stuff, and you guys have a wonderful rest of your day. Peace.